Today we celebrate a very long and proud sustaining tradition of democracy.
In 2010, Pennsylvania elected Tom Corbett as its 46th governor. Shortly thereafter, Corbett announced his budget for the 2011-2012 fiscal year, proposing to cut $860 million from education. 2 years later, those cuts are still haunting the governor as he considers a run for re-election.
Governor Corbett's job performance, and let's just use some ranges, somewhere between 30 and 34% positive.
Governor Tom Corbett's education cuts have hurt him in the state, specifically in southeastern Pennsylvania, in the collar counties surrounding Philadelphia.
He has cut an extreme amount of money from the public education system, and it's been testing pretty much through the roof.
There are seven counties in southeastern Pennsylvania: Philadelphia, Delaware, Chester, Montgomery, Bucks, and the Lehigh Valley, which includes Lehigh County and Northampton, making up 40% of the state's vote. To win any statewide race, history has shown a candidate needs to win four of those seven counties.
It's impossible to get elected or re-elected in this state without carrying the suburbs of Philly and the Lehigh Valley.
Democrats can bank on Philadelphia County and Delaware County going to Corbett's challenger, leaving five counties up for grabs. Those five are the suburbs. They are majority white and swing with the political tides, as the group they supported Governor Corbett in 2010. But those education cuts made in his first budget have left a sour taste in their mouths.
People do not want to see their schools defunded. They don't want to see programs that schools can't do. So education is going to figure prominently in the next election.
Republican strategists in the state say it's not just one issue that'll win or lose Governor Corbett's reelection. They say he has to convince the voters he's still the best man for the job.
The reason there were quote-unquote cuts to education in the governor's first budget was because Governor Rendell had taken phony stimulus money and used that in school district after school district, each of which knew that it was going away. But the fact of the matter is that Governor Corbett has a great story to tell. He's beginning to tell it much more aggressively. He will continue to do that.
But I have to say, I'm proud of you. I'm proud of the school district.
Republican strategist Charlie Giroux says Corbett has done the things he's campaigned on, like tightening government spending and not raising taxes. But convincing voters the state is on the right path may be tough. Corbett's ambitious plan to improve public roads is stuck in neutral, with the Republican-controlled House searching for enough votes to move it along.
The governor didn't get his agenda. That's a leadership issue. And the second question, and this is also important, you said you were going to deliver on your policies. Where are they?
Governor Corbett will be helped by a lengthy Democratic primary that's still months away, giving him an opportunity to boost his image while his competition beats each other up in a heated primary. For WashingtonExaminer.com, I'm Steve Doty.